Hello everyone and welcome to the St. Louis Park Summer Concert Series sponsored by the St. Louis Park Rotary Club. Happy to see everyone out here on this lovely Wednesday evening. We have concerts here until mid-August from 7 to 8:30, and I hope to see everyone here. This Saturday we actually have our large Summer of Love concert. It's from 6:30 to 9:30. It's Kevin Odegaard's large concert series. He does it every year. It's going to be a ton of artists. It's going to be a lot of fun, so I hope to see everyone here this Saturday. And here is the St. Louis Park Community Band.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome to our concert. I'm Barbara Lee, and I'm pleased to help announce our pieces this evening. So that first piece you heard, you probably would expect to hear at the end. It's called Curtain Call, but we played it for the beginning. So our next piece this evening, American River Songs, is based on traditional and composed music of an earlier time when the rivers and waterways were the lifelines of a growing nation. Composer Pierre LaPlante is French-Canadian by birth, but has lived almost his whole life in Wisconsin. We hope you enjoy our next piece, American River Songs.
Thank you.
For this next piece, we have a very special opportunity, but we have to have this special opportunity a few minutes to get set up here. So what a beautiful evening we have to play for you tonight. We're very, very happy. The weather's so nice. It certainly wasn't last night and this morning, but there you go. It's nice now. All right, there you go. So St. Louis Park has a very special program with this band called The Gift of Music. Many of you have probably already heard of this program. It was started in the 1990s when somebody asked for an instrument for their child to be able to play in the schools, and they couldn't afford this instrument. So the call was put out to the city and I don't know who else to see if anybody had instruments. And from there, the Gift of Music program was born. So we take donations of any instruments you might have in your home that you're not using anymore. They could be in any condition. We also take donations to help repair these instruments. We get them all ready, and then we give them to children in the schools, and children get to play an instrument. So this is a very important thing in a child's life. Some of you may know children who've started music, and they've really taken to it, and it can really change their lives. And many of us have also played instruments for our entire lives, so we can vouch for the fact that it's a very important thing in the life of a child. So if you have any instruments you would like to donate, you can either let us know in the band. Mr. Jim Rhodes would be happy to help you out with that. Otherwise, St. Louis Park City Hall, you can give them a call, and they can also get that to us. So for our next piece, the original title of our next piece is Has Anybody Seen My Gal? Most people recognize it as 5'2", Eyes of Blue. Originally written in 1914, it became the most popular during the Roaring Twenties and is most associated with Dixieland music. It's been covered by stars such as Dean Martin, Mickey Gilley, Mitch Miller, and Guy Lombardo. It was also used in the 1974 movie The Great Gatsby. Featuring our very own Dixieland quintet, here is 5'2", Eyes of Blue. So wasn't that fun? So in the city of St. Louis Park, I believe the number will be small, but I'm always curious, is there anybody in the audience this evening that is hearing and seeing us for the very first time? Oh, we do have a few. Welcome. Happy to have you here, and we hope you will come again. Normally, this concert is our last one of the summer season as we take the month of August off, but we're privileged to be able to present a concert this coming Sunday at Lake Harry Benchell at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. All right, so our next piece, described as a harpsichord gone country, Baroque Hoedown was originally written for the Moog synthesizer and featured on the album titled Kaleidoscopic Vibrations, Electronic Pop from Way Out. It was later that the piece became the theme song for Disneyland's Main Street Electrical Parade in 1972. Still used by Disney today, Baroque Hoedown has become one of the band's favorite pieces. So we present to you Baroque Hoedown. So my compliments to the fine young dancers we've had here up in front. Our fine young dancer is leaving. All right. All right, pause for switch of pieces of paper here. So this is undoubtedly, for most of us in the band, the most challenging piece we have taken on this summer. Composed in 1903, Slavonic Rhapsody No. 1 was originally written for either band, orchestra, or piano. Recognizing the brilliance of the work, Mayhew Lake transcribed it for band in 1904. It was recorded in 1909 by the John Philip Sousa Band and by the United States Marine Band in the 1960s. It's a fabulous showcase piece you are sure to enjoy, Slavonic Rhapsody No. 1.
Thank you. Thank you so very much. Isn't that a fun piece? It's really fun to be on that side of the band because people still have smoke coming off their fingers in the front few rows over here. Well, Judy Garland said it best. There's no place like home. And it's really fun in our summer season. We get to go out and explore some new concert halls in the outdoors and meet some new friends. But there's just something really special about coming back to our hometown and our community and our friends and our people. So we're so very glad you're spending a portion of your evening with us for supporting live music, because that's important. And really for us to honor the traditions of the past. This is our community within the band as well, and we're just really happy to share that with you. Speaking of our community, one of our members started writing music about 4 or 5 years ago. And he said, well, you know, you wanted us to do this trombone feature, and there aren't really that many good ones, so I hope you don't mind, but I tried writing one. And I said, wow, let's play it. And it was fantastic. Next thing you know, it gets published by a major music publisher. Bands all across the country are buying it. And he did this at the age of 91, which is pretty neat. So if you've not met Al Sweet, he's a role model for everybody. This is his fifth or sixth piece, and it's called Cavallina. And there was such a great story behind the trombone piece. I was like, okay, Al, this has got to be a great story. Why did you write this piece? I just like Latin music. So he likes it. We hope that you like it. This is our own Al Sweet's Cavallina.
For Al Sweet. Thank you, Al. So we have so many young dancers out here. Does anybody want to talk to me today? Any of you who are dancing? Want to come? Come on up. Come on up. What's your name?
Say it again.
Oh, okay. How old are you? You're four. Wow, and you're a great dancer. Is that your sister? All right, well, I'm sorry I'm so scary. Oh, this young man wants to talk to me. What's your name?
William.
William. How old are you?
Four.
And what do you do for a living?
Going camping.
You're going camping? Well, that's the life. All right. Nice to hear from some of the young members of our audience. I'm so glad you guys are enjoying our show. All right, our next piece this evening. Paul Linke was a German composer and theater conductor. He's considered the father of the Berlin operetta and holds the same significance for Berlin as does Johann Strauss for Vienna and Jacques Offenbach for Paris. Folie Bergeret is a building located in Paris that began as an opera house by the architect Plumeret. Established in 1869, the house gradually shifted to performing comic operas, revues, and dancing. Josephine Baker was brought from New York City to perform there in 1936. Composed by Paul Linke, this is the Folie Bergeret March.
Thank you so much. One of the things music can do, sometimes better than words, is say thank you. And before we play our next tune, we'd like to thank the St. Louis Park Public Schools and their driver, with whom out, we would have no percussion section, no music stands, sometimes no chairs. And they're with us every single concert this summer, and we just appreciate them so much. So could we give them a round of applause? And another thing music does well without words is thanks our veterans. And our next song is entitled Armed Forces Salute. So if you are a retired veteran, if you are current military, if you're a family member of a veteran or current military in any branch, when your theme song is called, including our National Guard, please stand and be recognized.
Thank you.
Well, we know that our little dancers are going to be back. If they'd like to be accompanied by big dancers, that would be okay too. Our next song is a trio of songs combined into one, which we call a medley. And now that we kind of have a little bit more open borders with Cuba, I know I have some friends that were able to take a cruise over there. They said the food was great, the antique cars were awesome, the music was spectacular. So we'd like to share some of Cuban folk tunes with you in a really neat arrangement called Danzas Cubanas.
Thank you.
You know, one of the neat things walking around this park is, at least for me, this I noticed some things that I had never noticed before. I got here early. I was coming back from the Mall of America with my family. They dumped me off here at 4:30. I enjoyed a little bit of Starbucks, came down and sat on a bench in the shade, and I turned around and there was a plaque on it, and it said James L. Rhodes. I'm like, well, that's really weird. There's a Jim Rhodes in our band. Oh my gosh, they gave him the bench while he was still living. How cool is that? That never happens. Usually you get a something on the wall or a plaque or a memorial thing after the fact, right? But this was so cool. And also in our audience is Lorraine Brasket, and Lorraine was one of the founding members, one of the founding eight members of the St. Louis Park Community Band back in the 1970s, and she'd like to come up and say a few words.
I need Jim Rhodes, though, up here with me. Jim, you got to come up here by me. Can you make it? I know you're older, too. Anyway, it was actually 3 years ago this month that I left the band after 42 years. I thought there were other people that could take care of it. But we had a president. Our president, Jim Rhodes, has been the president of the band since for 45 years. And I thought it would be time that he had a little recognition. So we have a gift for him that he can take home. It's for indoors. He doesn't have to go outside and work in the plants. So anyway, Jim, this is for you and Judy.
Well, aren't you nice? Thank you very much. This is great. No, don't sit down. That's okay. First of all, I walked the stairs. I didn't jump down, just to be sure. I'm as old as you, almost.
Yeah.
However, if I said to you, hey, kids, what time is it? What would you say? Who said that? Very good. What time? It's howdy doody time, right?
Oh, gosh.
Yes, you are that old. This is all labor of love, and we certainly enjoy coming out to our home base of St. Louis Park. We're very, very fortunate that these people have, a lot of these members, just for the fun of it, just how many have been in the band for 20 years or more? How about that? How many have been in the band that have their kids playing in the band at the same time they are?
Oh, they are.
And the kids can raise their hands. Isn't that something? And your husband, where are you, Dad? Oh, he's back there. That's the kind of spirit. And they don't live in St. Louis Park, by the way. They commute in. We have people that play in this band that come from all over, from the edge of northern Minnesota, or northern suburbs of Minnesota. That's you, Lynn. But also from across the river. And we all get together on Tuesday night to enjoy our hobby of music. And that's why it's important for kids. Because a lot of us started out when we were 10 years old and never quit. And that's the big thing. So when we talk about the instruments, I got to say one thing. We've given away over 700 instruments to kids in St. Louis Park, by the way. This is a St. Louis Park program that are able to have kids play in the band and orchestra because we want them to come and fill the ranks of our community band here. So it all started with Lorraine and eight people on Alabama Avenue.
That's right.
See, I don't forget these things.
Yeah, you do.
Memory's still there. So anyway, thank you very much. It's nice. This is a wonderful facility. It's named for the veterans, and it's that important that we do have a wonderful, by the way, Memorial Day here. It's very, very moving. The band has been playing it for over 20 years themselves. And we'd like to thank some of our major sponsors besides the city and the school district, Disney Corporation and the American Legion are our two biggest funders. So we sure appreciate that. Okay, on with the show.
You don't know how hard we worked with Minneapolis-St. Paul Airport to try and arrange a flyby during the Air Force song and Armed Forces salute. It worked in Richfield, but it didn't work tonight. It was a little late, but which is not like the military. But anyway, there it is. We'd like to play one last song for you. And one of the neat things is there are organizations out there and now websites. And for those of you that understand what life was like before the computer and before YouTube and before Flickr or Snitzer or whatever the latest phone app is, right? I mean, you understand, right, that
thanks to generations of people that would flock to live musical performances, some of these things that are our heritage have been kept. And there's a great website now that has circus music, which, as you know, Barnum and Bailey ran their last circus this past year. And so I'm a little sad. I grew up outside of Chicago. Don't hold it against me. And we used to go to the circus, the Barnum and Bailey Circus, every year, and it was a big deal when the circus came to town. So one of the neat things is there's a website now that's really working hard to protect that music that was written specifically for the circus, or from the late 1800s and the early 1900s. So we would like to close our concert today, again, by saying thank you for sharing a portion of your evening with us. We hope that it was as delightful for you as it has been for us. Thank you. And this is a piece, the one-hit wonders, and this actually was more than a one-hit wonder, but it was well before John Philip Sousa was conducting and writing for the Marine Band. Way back in 1894, there was a gentleman by the name of George Rosencrans. He was a little bit antisocial, lived in a corner of his house, because he wouldn't fix the leaks from the rain, and so it was really a little bit sad, but this piece has survived, thankfully, over 100 years later, and it's a little bit patriotic. You'll hear some themes that sound familiar to you. This is Dixie Doodle Dandy. Now, I'm going to make sure before you go home tonight that you've learned something. So when you hear a march, traditionally there's that last note at the end that's kind of like really loud that says, we're done now. The name of that note in musicians' terms is called a stinger, kind of like a bee. Bam, right? That sting is really sharp. And this song doesn't have one, but as you could hear, it's so tempting to add it anyway. So with your permission, we'd like to end with one last song that I'm sure you will all know that has a stinger. Thank you.
Again, many thanks for coming. Have a very safe trip home, and we hope to see you here again soon.